Move it up, son. Word.
Yeah. To all the killers and the $100 billers.
Yo, I drop the phone.
For real, niggas who ain't got no feelings. Feelings.
Just watch my back. I got your front.
Check it out now. Stuck off the realness, we be the infamous, you heard of us. Official Queensbridge murderers, tomorrow comes equipped for warfare. Beware of my crime family who got enough shots to share for all those who wanna profile and pose. Rock you in your face, stab your brain with your nose bone. You
wanna... Yo, what's up, GY312, Go Away Hip Hop R&R. We were here with the infamous Mobb, Prodigy Havoc, man. What's good with y'all?
What up? What's going on, man? Yeah. Chilling, South by Southwest.
Man, it's not quite the up north trip.
Nah.
Get it in there.
But, you know, it's the little, you know, the South trip, you feel me?
It has, I understand it's your first year. You guys been down to South by?
Yeah.
What's the experience so far?
It's been good, man. You know, we've been performing every night. Did a little surprise performance the other night. It's been real good.
Yeah.
Real good, yeah.
What about half?
You know, it's first time here, so you know I'm just taking it all in. You know what I mean? It's like one of the biggest conventions I ever been to. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was speaking. Well, you know, one of your guys, he was telling like he said he felt like the energy was different, and I was like, can you guys like speak on the energy? Like, how would you guys describe it being down here? And you know, there's like your hardcore Mobb fans, but it's like also like a lot of new upcoming guys that. The fans are coming down checking for them. Like, what would you guys kind of like describe that?
Yeah, to me, it's like, you know, they still hip hop fans. You know, they still know what time it is. You know, mm-hmm. so when we get on stage, you know, the energy is just there. You know, you can see in the crowd. There's a lot of, you know, the new younger crowd, and you can see a lot of, you know, it's a mixed crowd. You know what I mean? The older cats is out there, and It's real good, man. They showing a lot of energy. They into the music. They singing the lyrics with us while we on stage rhyming. So, yeah, it's real good, man. It's nice.
Dopeness, man. And yo, Hav, man. I want to ask you the question. Like, in terms of hip hop in 2012, like, what do you make of it?
I mean, you know, it's pretty dope. You know what I'm saying? Got a lot of new artists coming out there, bringing a lot of energy to the game. You know what I'm saying? A lot of dope lyricists. You know, I'm feeling what's going on. You know what I mean? I try to pay, you know, a little attention to what's going on. And I got hope for the rap game, you know what I'm saying, for 2012. It's looking good. It's too many new producers out there. The name, like, what's homeboy name? Cardiac. He's like a beast on the beats, you know what I'm saying? He definitely made a couple of joints that, you know, Get a nigga open and shit, but it's a lot of them out there, man. But I'm feeling good about it, cause you know it just inspired me, cause I just, you know, that's how I started from day one, just listening to other people out there and being inspired. So no matter, even if you know I've been in the game for so many years, if you can't get inspired, then you know what you here for. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, things have to inspire you, or you just bored with it. So I'm still being inspired.
And what about you, man? Prodigy, you know, it's been like 3+ years. You back in the game like you never left, still dropping, you know, bombs and killing the game. Like, how's this experience been for you, like, back into it?
Oh, man, it just feels great. You know, it feels great to have, you know, my career and my family, my friends, you know what I mean? Like, because when you locked up, you know, you get most of that snatched from you. You know, you in there. And everybody out here, and you like, damn, you feeling like an asshole, locked up. Like, yeah, am I fucked up? You know what I mean? So it definitely make you appreciate your freedom. You know what I mean? Once you in there, you understand, like, damn, this is not what you want to be. You know, you want to be out there doing what you want to do when you want to do it. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, definitely, it feels good to be out here. And I definitely got newfound respect, you know what I mean, for... you know, just having my freedom, period, man. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Was there anything that you missed in particular when, you know, you were in the joint? Were you like, oh, man?
Yeah, it's going to the studio. Going to the studio making songs. That was, you know, one of the main things that I missed a lot. you know, be able to go in and make songs, because that's my addiction. You know what I mean? I'm addicted to rap music. You know, when I hear other people, you know, whoever, Jay-Z, Kanye, Drake, whoever it is, you know, the new artists, it doesn't matter.
So you rock with Drake?
Yeah, whoever. You know, I rock with everybody as long as, you know, they making something that's unique and creative, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? I definitely rock with it, you know what I mean? And when I hear artists put out their new music, you know, I get it. It makes me want to go to the studio, you know what I mean? It amps me up, because I'm real competitive when it comes to rap music, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So it makes me want to go, damn, I got something hot. Damn, I got to make something better than that right now, you know what I'm saying? And I couldn't do that. You know what I mean? I just had to listen to everybody's music, and I couldn't go in and record nothing. You know, I was able to write, but I wanted to record and get it out of my system. I wanted to hear what it sounded like when I recorded, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And I couldn't do that. So, yeah, that's one of the main things I miss, man, was making music and recording music.
Was there anything that was inspiring you, like when you were in jail, in the same token?
Yeah, just listening, you know, listening to mixtapes, listening to all the new albums I was dropping. I was getting all of that stuff. You know what I mean? Definitely, a lot of the, you know, the new artists, like you said, like Drake and, you know, Wiz Khalifa, a lot of the new artists definitely inspired me, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I know Half was telling me, like, for, like, producers, you know, different guys that's kind of been getting them charged, who's really been kind of, like, amping you, like, kind of from, like, the competitive nature that you speak of, where you like, man, I'm checking for that?
Man, I can't even put my finger on, like, one or two. It's just, like, it's a bunch of artists, man. Even like, you know, the older artists that's been out for a while to the new artists. I'm just like, I'm in love with rap music. So if I hear anybody put out a song where the beat is ill and they saying some slick stuff in their rhymes, that make me want to go straight to the studio. You mm-hmm. know what I mean? Yeah.
Man, and I read some excerpts of the book, you know, and there's one part that really stuck out to me. You mentioned that. You said you felt like you were 16 for like 17 years.
Yeah.
And like you kind of feel like the maturation now. Like, you kind of speak on that?
Yeah, I mean, you know, we came in the game when we was like 15, 16 years old with Mobb Deep and, you know, our rap career. So it's like, you know, once you come in the game and just, you know, take off, you know, you go on tour and, you know, you're doing all these videos and shows, and that's now your life is engulfed with this music and this lifestyle, you know, you really don't have a chance to grow up, you know what I mean? Because you out there just running. So it's like almost like you suspended in time, you know what I mean? That's how I felt, like, you know what I mean? I felt like, you know, ever since we first came into the game, it felt like to me personally, like my mind was like suspended in that time. And then when I got locked up, I realized, I looked back at everything like, wow, you know, all that time, I never really thought like how I'm thinking now. I never thought about real like longevity as far as like business and just certain other things. I was making like a lot of terrible decisions and just a lot of bad moves that I was making. And a part of those decisions, why I was making those decisions was because, you know, I never really grew up. We just been on tour in the studio, and we were stuck in our little zone, you know what I mean? Suspended in our little time zone, a Mobb Deep, you know what I mean? I never really stopped and stepped out of that, you know what I mean? And looked at and observed it from an outsider's point of view, you know what I mean? I was always inside and just moving every day, you know what I mean? But once you get a chance to stop and really stop and do nothing else but look at what's going on, you start seeing things differently, you know what I mean? You start seeing like, damn, why did I do that? What was I thinking about when I did that? I wasn't even thinking. I was just moving. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. And just kind of just going back, you know, to the music, you know. Man, really, really, really dope, you know what I'm saying, music you guys been cranking out. Like, what's next for, you know, for the rest of the year and, you know, just Mobb Deep?
Yeah, I mean, we just working on music nonstop. You know what I mean? Nonstop. Mobb Deep music, Prodigy music. That's what we got. Like, you know, Havoc's production. Havoc's, you know, solo albums that he works on. You know, it's just nonstop working, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Nonstop working, man. We sometimes, people get confused. They see us doing outside projects. Like, they'll see me do a H.N.I.C album, and they'll mistake that for, oh, he not fucking with Mobb Deep no more. but that's not where you want what the case is. You know what I mean? It's basically just another check. Like, why continue to keep doing this when we can also do this and make double the money? You know what I'm saying? Right. If you got it in you to do that. You know what I mean? If you got enough in you to crank out that much material, why not do it? You know what I mean?
You know, I have, like, you know, speaking on, like, your solo project, like what's the bar that you've been raising for yourself, you know, as it relates to the 2012 shit, that habit, you know?
I mean, I just keep it simple, you know what I'm saying? I just go with the flow, you know what I mean? I try not to overthink anything, you know what I'm saying? And I just try to make, you know, stuff that, you know, appeals to me, you know what I'm saying? Appeals to my peers and just keep it moving, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, don't overthink it. Just try to have fun with it and you know, remember why I'm in the game in the first place is because I love it, you know what I'm saying? So I'm going to do this music because I love it. And then, you know, business comes second, you know what I'm saying, for me, you know what I mean?
And I also, you know, I'm a, you know saying, Southside Chicago native, man. I saw the collaboration you guys had with LEP Bogus Boys.
Yeah.
Like, how did you guys, you know, link?
That was Peak Neck right there.
Yeah, I was actually, when I was locked up, I was reading an article that they had in a Double XL, I believe it was. And I had seen their name around before, but, you know, they got that kind of name, like Bogus Boys. Why do they call themselves Bogus? You know what I mean? So I'm reading their article just because I was curious. And I liked their story. You know, I was feeling their story. I was like, oh, they some hood dudes, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I was like, yeah, we should, they sound like something that Mobb Deep should connect with, you know what I mean? So when I got home, I just reached out to them and we did it.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna flip it real quick, talk of like a little sports basketball. They just fired your boy Dan Tony, man.
Say what?
Yeah, you think it was because Rose and the Bulls were dragging him like that, man?
I'm pretty sure, you know, them GMs don't play that. You know what I'm saying? They're like, yo, you know what I'm saying? You gotta go. You know what I mean? But, you know, hopefully, you know, much love to, you know, your boy. But I hope they, you know, get their stuff together, man, you know? Mm-hmm. The Knicks is my team, so you know.
So you still riding out with the Knicks?
Yeah, all day long, you know what I mean? All we need is, you know what I'm saying, my boy from Orlando, and we be good. We put the pieces together, you feel me?
Mm-hmm. Prodigy, man, if you had to put money on the table, right? If the playoffs started tomorrow, who you riding out with?
Oh, man. I don't even know to tell you the truth, man. I would have to consult with Hav. I'd be like, yo, son. What you think?
Oh man, check it. Let me see who I'm gonna ride out with for the playoffs to the championship. New Orleans, there you go. New Orleans. Yeah.
Wait, you talking about New Orleans when they had Chris Paul, or you talking about the Clippers now?
Nah, I'll talk about that.
Oh no, Oklahoma.
There you go. Damn.
That's my final. I'm with you, my dude. We
right,
here.
Right.
Yo, we getting ready to get up out of here, man. I want to see, like, what's your Twitter handles? What's the best way people can get in contact with Mobb? You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? You can catch Havoc on at The Real Havoc. You know what I'm saying? That's the same. And I got the Instagram, The Real Havoc. You know what I mean? It's all good.
My joint is Prodigy Mobb Deep.
There you go.
H.N.I.C. Part 3, the album, coming real soon. You can get the mixtape right now on complex.com. It's a free download. You know what I mean? Look out for that Mobb Deep project, man. We busting our ass on that Mobb Deep joint, so look out for that.
Indeed, man. Yo, man, much respect and love, man. Appreciate you guys, you know what I'm saying? Like this convo having us, man. GY312, R&R, GoWhereHipHop.com, Mobb Havoc. Prodigy, yo, we up out of here, man. South by Southwest 2012. What up?
Yeah.